always telling me they wish they had more Spanish-speaking doctors.
When I was applying to college, personally, it was a little hard for me too.
What really motivated me, prep, my mentor, and at the end of the day, my family.
If I start believing that I can do this, then guess what? I'm gonna do this.
One of our visions in Alliance and Mentorship and creating MiMentor.org, which is a mentoring network of students and healthcare professionals, is to really think about how we can create spaces so that mentors and mentees that are interested in furthering and improving our communities with respect to healthcare can get together.
I'll tell you, you're flying over Hawaii. You're getting ready for your Mai Tai on the beach, and somebody over there, the speaker says, is there a doctor on the plane? What are you gonna say? Oh no, I'm on vacation. Absolutely not. You are on call at all times. This is why we're here. This is what we want to do.
Five-minute elevator pitch. If I were to say, tell me about yourself.
Today we've had over 400 students show up, over 100 mentors show up, and there's been some really good conversations around what is mentoring, how do you do it effectively, how are you able to then take that relationship and grow in your career, and then more importantly, how do we better serve our patients in the community, given the fact that healthcare is such a challenging field.
For high school students and people who have their GEDs but haven't gone to college, it selects 1,000 individuals every single year. It funds unmet need. So some people think of it as a full ride, but it really is unmet need.
When I was applying to college, they actually told me, we can't really afford sending you to a four-year university. So what I ended up doing was applying to UC's and CSU's behind my parents' back by getting a fee waiver for the application.
Getting into the habit of trying to teach yourself if you don't get something in class or by asking, reading the book, you have to take the extra steps to make it happen. It's not gonna happen on its own or, you know, you have to put in the effort now.
Start thinking about when you will be taking your SATs, ACTs, what schools require what exam.
Strawberries. I sit down on my couch and it's one of those big baskets of strawberries. So I got, instead of cushions, I got big strawberries sitting next to me. Poppy, I sit down on couch.
Strawberries.
While next to me is what?
Kale.
What am I dodging as I walk down the hall?
Kale.
What's in my bathtub?
Kale.
Any opportunity I have to show what I can, teach what I can, share what I can, so that these students can be successful, especially in the health sciences field, there's such a need, such a demand.
I want to become a physician. It was, for me, a dream that kind of just never left me.
I knew that I had to get good grades to go to medical school to be a doctor, but I really didn't know what else you had to do. Do it and you really want to do it, you will not regret it, and you are needed in so many ways.
A lot of the students want to become doctors, nurses, physician's assistants, but they don't know how, and so having a mentor walk them through what's important is kind of the beginning of the conversation, and then they can go online on MiMentor.org and continue that conversation and connect with other mentors that are in the field